Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Dr. Srihari. I am from MOH, Ludhiana. Thank you, everyone, for giving me an opportunity to present my paper over here. And our study is on association of hypomagnesemia with type 2 diabetes mellitus and its complications. Why we are doing this study? Because, as we all know, now India is becoming a hub for diabetes mellitus and baki non-communicable diseases. So, as we belong to Southeast Asian region, there is a chance of increasing, the study shows that there the prevalence of diabetes mellitus will be increasing about 84% by 2045. So why this study? Diabetes is one of the fast growing health challenge of the 21st century, and most of it 90% is of type 2 diabetes mellitus. And nowadays we are facing an epidemiological transition. That is, previously we are facing more of communicable diseases, but nowadays we are facing more of non-communicable diseases like diabetes, hypertension and baki lifestyle diseases. And micronutrients have been investigated as a potential preventive and treatment agents in diabetes mellitus and its complications. And magnesium is one of the micronutrients which is especially important in this regard, but it is an under-investigated micronutrients. And when we went to the literature, various studies from different parts of our country shows different results actually. Somewhere like magnesium have an association, and somewhere like magnesium is not having any association with the diabetes and its complication. So we decided to make a study on it so that we can implement magnesium in our routine diabetic workup, and we can easily supplement if there is a association between the diabetes and its complications. Aim of the study was to determine the prevalence of hypomagnesemia in type 2 diabetes mellitus and to assess the correlation between hypomagnesemia and diabetic microvascular and macrovascular complications, in which microvascular complications includes diabetic retinopathy, diabetic neuropathy and diabetic nephropathy, and macrovascular complications mainly includes coronary artery diseases, cerebrovascular diseases and peripheral artery diseases. And the objective of our study was to reduce the delay and the occurrence of diabetic microvascular complication and macrovascular complication by supplementing magnesium if the study proves there is a relation between hypomagnesemia and diabetic complications. And materials and methodology, it was a cross-section study, and we took 150 patients that presented to our hospital OPD and NPD. And actually for the classification, we use ADA guidelines for diagnosing diabetes mellitus, and for diabetic retinopathy we use fundus examination in which if there is non-proliferative or proliferative diabetic retinopathy, and for neuropathy we use the scoring system called Michigan scale, which includes both physical examination and questionnaire, and for nephropathy we use the criteria like spot albumin creatinine ratio and the EGFR. Inclusion criteria: adults with age more than or equal to 18 years who are diagnosed with type 2 diabetes mellitus according to the ADA guidelines and which were present for more than or equal to 5 years. And exclusion criteria includes type 1 diabetes mellitus obviously, and baki rest of the conditions which would affect the serum magnesium levels. That includes history of excessive alcohol intake, then patients on drugs and diuretics like diuretics, aminoglycosides, then amphotericins, then untreated or poorly controlled similar thyroid or adrenal insufficiency, then history of magnesium like intake of magnesium containing multivitamin tablets, then pregnancy, lactation, sepsis, renal failure which will be defined as EGFR less than or equal to 30%, and malabsorption syndromes. Results: when we went to the results of our study, it was shown that in our study around 44.7% was female and 53% were male, and the mean age group of the study population was 62 plus or minus 10 years. In that, female were having higher mean age of 63 plus or minus 9. And when it comes to the HbA1c of the studied population, only 16.7% were having a normal HbA1c, even though in diabetic patients we take 7 as the marker for HbA1c, and rest were like above 6.5%. Then when we came to the magnesium levels, in our study the prevalence of hypomagnesemia was observed to be 40 patients, that makes around 26.7%. And when we came to the complications, first of all, macrovascular complication, the most leading was coronary artery disease in these sort of patients, then followed by cerebrovascular disease and the peripheral artery disease. And when it came to diabetic retinopathy, around 64.7% were proved to have diabetic retinopathy by fundus examination. And when it came to diabetic nephropathy, around 30 31% were not having diabetic nephropathy, but around 68% were having diabetic nephropathy using the SPORT ACR or the eGFR. And when it comes to diabetic neuropathy, around 20.7 patients were having diabetic neuropathy, which were diagnosed with the like Michigan scoring scale. This gave the master table of the relationship between the hypomagnesemia and the macrovascular complication when it came to CA, coronary artery disease. Only 9 patients were having hypomagnesemia, which gave a p-value of 0.6, which were not significant. And when it came to coronary cerebral vascular disease, only 4%, that means 10% were having cerebral vascular disease. And peripheral artery disease, only 2% were having, 5% were having hypomagnesemia. When it came to microvascular complications, diabetic retinopathy, patients having diabetic retinopathy, only 13 patients were having hypomagnesemia. That makes a percent of 32%, and the p-value was 0.6. Again, it is insignificant. And diabetic nephropathy, only 27 patients were having hypomagnesemia. That makes a 67%. Again, the p-value is insignificant, 0.88. And when it comes to diabetic neuropathy, only 10 patients were having hypomagnesemia, that is 25% were having hypomagnesemia. There also the p-value is 0.4, and that too is insignificant. So when it comes to the conclusion, there was no statistical correlation between hypomagnesium level and the future development of micro and macrovascular complication type 2 diabetes mellitus. And we came to a conclusion from our study, there is no need of making magnesium level a routine part of the diabetic workup. Thank you.
All were
non-diabetic, sir.
All were non-diabetic?
All were non-diabetic. More than 5 years.
HbA1c was more than?
6.5, sir.
All of
them? AD guidelines, sir.
Some sort of a negative study.
Actually, we thought of like if there is a positive correlation, then we will make magnesium a routine workup in our diabetic workup. And we can supplement magnesium easily so that we can prevent the complication. But our study came to be a negative study.
But as far as the literature says, for people having hypomagnesemia, they have more of
a complication. Actually, we went through the literature, sir. From different part of our country, different literatures are coming. Like some part of the country, there is a positive correlation between diabetic nephropathy, and somewhere like there is no correlation between diabetic nephropathy. So we were interested in like what our region or our institution has studied. Or what to make the protocol.
But the most of the studies are in favor of hypomagnesemia causing the diabetic complication, isn't it?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks, sir.